Hi, and welcome back to our Stopmotion film project. We had a misfire today. I started and forgot to record, and that's typical me. But we are making branches to the tree we started on yesterday. I have bent some knee in aluminium to the branches, and now I have to saw and change the screens. So we can see what we are doing. Like this. So, and what I was talking about it was this small knees in a aluminium tube so I can fit these inside them and put them on here. That way I can kind of I have done the same here, so the clay get too soft and they kind of fall down a little over time, so it's easier on this way. I was a little delayed today because Wirecast have an idea. It will want to help me, and I hate when software tries to help you. So it shut everything off, and it can hear another mic in the vicinity. So every time I'm going in there, when I start up, I have to fight it to get the second mic on. And then you get a little frustrated. And I have told it you can take the, there is a setting so it automatically detects feedback, but I have turned that off, but as many software programs, they will never accept you do things they, you cannot mean that. Are you sure you mean it? Yes, I am. Don't do it. But it decides otherwise. Anyway. But I guess we have to live with that. So, and then we can put these on. sure, just one on this one. Yep. I think I need some more glue in this one. Oops. It's running on empty. And that's the shortest one. And we have to take a little off later on, but we'll do that when needed. I think I'll put some more glue in this one. We will need it later on. But it's easier to have in a little one like this to handle than the big guy. Cool. Then we can glue a couple of sticks more or whatever. to. I think maybe we should let this dry, and then we have the other one in the fridge for yesterday. Well, from yesterday. Maybe I should have taken it out just a little before we went online on air. I think we'll let it stand a little. I'll start on another one. Thank you. And another one. Basket in here, then we didn't have to run by. This is too short, so I thought I have some more up on the loft, but we will not run for that now. So what I was thinking of doing is putting these two together. And then we had a three. So that's not that precise because you're holding in the hand. Well, it don't have to be. See, then they are kind of not that precise on here, but that don't matter in this case. And we can do like this instead. That was better. Okay. see. Should have made this first. I need an extra hand. We have one of those. Just to hold it by like making a hook. But just some pieces so I can do it with one hand. The intern has gone home. I'm of course joking. There is no intern. There ought to be an intern. Anybody who want to go without pay beside me. Don't need that anymore. And I didn't get any longer with the intro today. There's simply not enough hours in the day. But I will go for it in this weekend. Because tomorrow we have to, in kids' workshop, we have to keep on building on the doll castle. And my granddaughter Ida comes visit, so my co-host. she was disappointed last time because she had told all her friends in the kindergarten that she was coming on YouTube, and then was it that our Wirecast problem started. So I couldn't do it. Maybe it was her brother Frederick in the another kids workshop, kids YouTube. Let's see. Oh yes, we did build dollhouse, and she was on the net, but it was Frederick that went bad. But that's first on Friday. And that was again, that's a mic problem with Wirecast. So we will keep on with the dollhouse, and and put roof on it, and separate the rooms and whatnot. But you never know how far you will get, because having a little girl in that age, 6 years around, things never go according to plan. And that's okay. It's mostly about having fun. It's young me, while we haven't covered it all up in clay, we can one here.
So.
I think we need to have a little robot hoover running around here. I'm afraid it will get caught up in all the wires. And then we can use, what can we use? Use a little stick to mark the holes. Thank you. And like now, Windows are seeking after a solution on the problem, and they have never, in all the years I have run Windows, and that is many years, found any solution on anything. So just close the damn thing and don't try to find any solutions. Now I can do like this, and then I know where to sit the branch. Put the branch, or what we should say. Next one here. I think I'm running out of sticks in a certain size. And these thin things here are much thinner. And these are spruce. the others are bamboo. Grill stay. These are real wood. I think we need some gold. Kind of a little flat over here. I think it's It's using a lot of CPU tonight. I don't know why that is. Maybe because Microsoft have are doing something in the background. A new update. It's Tuesday. I don't want that update. Last time they updated, then I was not able to start Wirecast anymore, and I have never gotten it up again if I wasn't lucky enough to have a restore store point. Can move up there. finish. Okay. Just so I can see where the hole is. Just put that make a little hole in the top to the wire. I think so. One. Come on. Down. And that was tightened. Thank you. in the ceiling. Okay. Subway Crest. Flesh. So up again. Flesh Crest. Trying to answer my friend Imgard, but when I went over there, it went bad. So it must wait. Or before we know it, everything is crashing. So don't move. Hi, TD. They're pouring out. I have to wait a little while. should have made some smaller holes. Then I could have taken a smaller stick. But I didn't. One, two, three, four, five, six. I will see if I have that many. Oh, I don't. I can write it in it. A, oh, maybe I should do some. I write it for you. A, K, D. Write with one hand is difficult. And P E F C E P T E O N E two null U S B That's the name of it. I think so. The problem is always that the USB mic are sometime a little difficult to get some good ones of them, I think. But I'm happy with this one. And I have another one in the workshop. But I don't know what the name of that is, but I don't think that's so good. Not as good as this one, I think. Okay. Is that cheap or expensive for you? $821. Real, is that expensive? Or is it cheap? Another good one is a Heil PR40. That's a really good mic for voice. But my voice is so terrible anyway, so I don't think that help. Oops. Okay. Yeah, but I think the sound is exactly as important as the video. It's horrible to hear on a bad mic if you are streaming, but I know my voice are not the best one out there. I have a bad radio voice, but that's the only one I have, so the voice, I mean. So a little more distance. to it. And a little more down. Oop. But the one I have in the other room is the same price, so that's not cheaper. But what you want is a highly directionally mic. So you don't take all the noise in the room. And in that respect is the Heil PR40 the best one. But then you have to talk right into the barrel, right into. I will get a stick. Okay, I had some more of those bamboo kinds. Where's the hole? Now I can't find the hole anymore. Oh, up there. Everything have moved. And we will take the hard way. Put some glue on. Do the same with this one. TD, do you know of the podcast and named Twit with Leo Laporte and it is copy here. Why did it do this? Why did it? Okay. Okay, I cannot put links in here. So, but it's a tech live broadcast, and the link is live dot twit dot tv. It's the one you, if you see here, oops. And get a little closer. Just a minute and I will focus. And I will focus close so you can see the link. Oops, that way. Now you can see the link. live.twit.tv. That's a really good podcast or netcast with a lot of different tech stuff. And they are using the mic, the guy who are on now in the, on the screen now is Steve Gibson, and he's a security specialist expert. And it's all of it is free, and you can, if you want, you can learn a lot of them. Here talking into a Heil PR40 mic. It's a really good mic, a little more expensive than mine, but not much. So. And they have a lot of different programs where they talk of Apple and Windows and tech news and whatever. And they are sending 24/7. So, of course, a lot of it is rebroadcast, but I think you will enjoy it if you try it once, but you can see for yourself. a lot of the stuff I do here, I have learned from them. I have followed the guy who have it, Leo Laporte, for a lot of years. That looks not that good. This is round. And the color don't matter. So we will put that aside to the glue, all right. Yeah, motorsports. But that's kind of the only thing I... Formula One. And I guess that's because when I was young, I drove a little rally, so. But that's many years ago. But I guess you like soccer or football, as we call it here. You have a lot of good, very good players in Brazil. That's one thing you guys are really good at. And you are playing a fun and interesting type of football. Entertaining. So, off with that. It's not 100% dry yet, so have to be a little careful. This white carpenter glue here, it takes 24 hours before it really is good. Can you have a good evening, TD? Or a good night, I guess it would be. Did I make any holes here? No. I think I will. Get a little balance. A little balance. Couple of holes here. soup. Long way. And make one more. No, wrong hand. Easier this way. Put a little glue. This. mind a little. This and same with this one. So and then we will have ourselves a little stick to put in here. Okay. Then we need a little knee to put on. We can do it in here. I take a stick.
Hot.
Very hot. I'll take a saw. See how it fits. And we will take it here. And we will let that dry too and see if the one from the fridge we took out are okay now to work on or what. It shouldn't be that cold anymore. Much better. What is this? Okay. Okay. More branches than on it, it was the kit. Get room for the fingers and the tools. Yep, a tree. Thank you. It's an old oak. Or at least that's what it meant to be. That is hollow inside. I'm producing a lot of trees. The story in the movie I am making, a stop motion animation, is taking place in a forest in the Stone Age, where two boys are roaming around and living together with their families. But as you can see, I don't know if you saw it, but I'm working on several trees at the same time, because when I have fumbled around with this oil-based clay a little while, it gets very soft. And then I let it cool a little and go on to the next one. So it's a little back end. And forward. And then you can see they start to drip when the clay gets too soft. And this here needs a little more strings. That was better. It's a oil-based clay. And it don't stiffen at any time. Because when I have, the reason I use this is that I can reuse it over and over again. And when I'm finished, I scan the tree and then I print it in my 3D printer. So you get a tree like this. This is another type, but you get the idea. As you can see here, it's a big hand, but the result is a little hand like this. And the reason I make it so big is I can better make details on a hand like this, and then I scan it, and then afterwards I can I can print it out in any size I want. And here's a foot that I made as big. But these I make a mold of, and then I make a silicone cast where I put wires in the fingers so they can grip. And I can animate them. So that's how it works. how it works. Sorry. I have a cold. Keeps getting through. And I cannot grip with my fingers because there are oil on them. And the color of the clay don't have any meaning. That's just because when I order clay, I order a big bunch, and then that was the only color they had that much I wanted. Because I use a lot of it. Stick out. Why? Okay. have already made it too hot. And it's because I have two big soft boxes light on, so it gives a lot of wattage, so they get hot. I think we will put that one over so we can take another one. This is too hot now. Sorry. Oh, irritating. and get it down a little. My shoulders hurt. Thank you. But there is a lot of them to make. These first one, I have made a lot of those, maybe 100 or 200, but they are kind of fill trees, but then you have to, and they look more or less similar, all of them. But then you need some with another. I knew, I use silk paper. I'll show you. I will show you. First, I make a wireframe like this. You better see it when I put the hand up behind it. Of thread, and then I glue these on. So that's a big work, and you can see this one is more neat work to done, to be done. So but I'm always thinking of if I can come up with an easy way to do it, but that's, I'm not come up with anything good yet, but hope I will, because it takes a long time. Thank you. It kind of has to, because when you're making a close-up, I'm gonna shoot the animation with a Canon 5D camera, and you know, they kind of reveal every flaw in what you're doing, so that's why. And then I have made a big one too, and have to make big, I will hold this up so you can see, but don't be seasick, see, over behind, I will zoom in, and I will focus on it. So, you can see there's a big one, and I need that because when you are making a close-up, you have to have some light. Okay. The boys are gonna have a kind of treehouse up there, so you need it. But as you saw, it's not finished yet, but I will only make that one in clay, and I have to make one similar in a small one. A copy of it in small. That is kind of a little worse because it have to look more or less exactly the same. But I kind of take one step at a time, and then I hope to solve all of it when I get there. And I have to make, I have to, the reason I had a little pause in this is I had to yeah, that was a good music, but I built a box for that, so you cannot hear. Oh yes, you can hear it, but it's not running tonight. But where is it? Here is it. As you can see, it's built in a box, so because that was a lot of noise, so I had to do that, but it's not running tonight. I hadn't had time to scan, and you know, it takes a lot of time to print, when it's run, it runs, but you have to keep an eye on it all the time, and stuff happens, and then it takes a lot of time to take care of it. And then I had a problem, the extruder in the printer burned out, so I had to get a new one of that, and I had to get it from US. That's maybe because of my bad English. No, the extruder in it burned out, and then I had to get a new one from US. That took a lot of time. It took a while before it came back here. But now we have put it in, and it's working. And I have, this one is printed with the new extruder. So it's working again. The problem is that I have a I have a very small studio with I have the studio where I am in now, and then I have the workshop in beside, in the next door in, and then this is out in the other room. But everything, as when everything is so small, you can hear computer noise and that 3D printer noise, and the mic takes it up, all of it. And I have a mic in the workshop, and I had have a mic here, and but I don't have anything out where the printer stand or is. I would like to have 600 square meters. That would be nice. And I could use it. But I don't. And it will cost a fortune, so. To rent or buy something like that. So there will not be anything of that kind. But also, one of the ideas behind this is, can one make a project like this on a shoestring budget? And that's kind of the what's it called? The challenge. Because when Pixar do things like this, or like other people, there are hundreds of people working on models, and they put millions of dollars into it. And I don't have millions of dollars. So and I have already put a lot of money into it. But it's kind of a labor of love, and that's, and I am in a position where I can do it, so. So I'm happy about that. And as you maybe know, the reason I call it an open stop motion project, that is because I want along the way others to participate. I cannot, the physics stuff I cannot get other people to do because we cannot send it around, but I have on Google Plus, I have about 40,000 followers, so some of them I know very well, some of them are very creative, so I hope some of them will help me with stuff they can, and with stuff I think bits, we can always send bits around. I need voices to the figures, and I need music, and I need, and I cannot sing or play a note other than on the radio. So, but I know people who can, and on the Facebook I have, I think, 250,000 followers. So I hope some of all those people will, I can manage to get them to help a little. Not all of them, but some of them. Thank you. I hope so. I'm an old guy, so that's maybe my last big project, because it will take a long time. But it had been a dream of mine for a lot of years, so now or never. And so long you are with a good health, and then why not? We all have our little dreams. But I think this will be it for today, because now the time is midnight here, and it will take at least 4 hours to upload this. And tomorrow we will make a kids workshop. And what time is that? I cannot remember, because my granddaughter is visiting tomorrow, 3 p.m. my time. And we will keep on with the doll, get on with the doll castle he was building on last Wednesday. And I will say many thanks to you who was watching, and thank for you in the, thanks to you in the chat. It's everything goes easier when we have, I have something to, someone to talk to and talk with. So thank you and good night, and I will go to reruns if I can find the right mouse. I can. Good night.